Well, the time has come for the first weekly update of the off-season. Yo, what is going on, everybody? Welcome to Philly Side Silver Media. And today we have a very big announcement, right? A name change has come to my operation. Now, guys, before I get into this video, please subscribe if you haven't yet. Please hit the notification bell, please like this video, comment on this video, share this video, and let's get into this. So we have a lot to talk about in this one, right? You see the change. You see the change, right? A new name, no more Philly Sensitive Videocast on YouTube. It is going to be Philly Sensitive Media, right? So I'm very, very proud to announce that, right? So the Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, all is going to be Philly Sensitive Media. So it was a little bit confusing before with Instagram being Philly Sat Stove and then YouTube being Philly Sat Stove Videocast and then all these different names. It just was really confusing. It wasn't like that confusing, but everything is just going to be called one thing, right? Of course, everything was Philly's Hot Stove, but now it's just going to be Philly Sat Stove Media, right? Which I really, really like because Philly Sat Stove Videocast, in my opinion, limited me to just doing videocasts, right? I want to do podcasts. I want to do breakdown videos. I want to be doing other stuff, right? And I'm not gonna lie, I mean, guys like, you know, John Boy Media, I mean, they definitely inspired me a little bit, right? I mean, they definitely inspired me. I'd be lying to you if I said that they weren't. And I think this is a step in the right direction. I think this is a step towards, you know, more professionalism, right? I already think that I've accomplished that, but I just want to be as professional as I can. So I'd like to thank the name Philly Sat Stove Videocast for 2.5 great years. You know, it served me well, but it is time to move on to something greater, which is Philly Sat Stove Media. It's a new logo. I'm in the logo. And for those who are asking, in the hype video posted on Instagram, I don't know if you've seen that yet, and in my logo with a Philly P is photoshopped out, and that is for copyright reasons. Yes, that is for copyright reasons, because I just do not want to deal with any of that trouble. You know, I haven't had any, you know, trouble yet. Of course, my old logo with Arper had the Philly P in it. They didn't give me any trouble about it, but you never know. I mean, they probably were going to at some point. So now they can't because the copyrighted logo is not there. So I'm very, very happy about that, right? So, you know, a couple changes on the thumbnail. We got ourselves a new outro. The intro music does remain the same. The outro music has been changed. So go check that out. I don't want to give it away what it is. Much improved outro. So I updated a lot of things. Launching of a website with a weekly article about a Philly's topic. If you're interested in writing an article for my website, feel free to email me, phillysatstovemedia@gmail.com. You can go DM me on Instagram, @phillysatstovemedia. Or you can DM me @HarperFanatics. So you can go call our text hotline number, which is not going to change, 267-225-3292. So Philly Satstove hotline is kind of on hold right now because of the fact that it is the off season. But that will be coming back as we near next season. So as we get closer to next season, we'll be returning. If we get a lot of voicemails, maybe we'll do it, in January. I don't know. But it is time for the first weekly update of the 2021-2022 off season. I hope to be able to eventually upload, of course it's going to be only like audio only, it's going to be in a podcast version, these videos on MP3 file on Spotify, so you can go listen to it. You won't be able to see me, of course, it's going to be a podcast. But I eventually hope to be able to, spread out my content a little bit to other sites, right? It's going to be podcast version, as I said. But just to get my name out there a little bit more. Hopefully we're going to be able to, be on Spotify very, very soon. That is my hope. So enough about my new operation. I'm very excited, though. So some big changes coming, right? So the Twitter account's going to be much more active. I deactivated my old Twitter account just because I just followed way too many people. And this was just going to take too much time to fix that all up. So I just deactivated it and then just started a new one. So go check out all in the link in the description section. So thank you guys so much for all your support. I'm very excited to start this new beginning. So, some Phillies talk, right? So yesterday on the Phillies Ads to Videocast, I discussed the free agent, preview video. Always start off the offseason, right? That's the first video you always do. So I talked about players that are going to elect in free agency. So a couple more players are going to be joining this list. As the Phillies announced last night that they outrighted the following six players and going to be electing free agency. I already heard about Odubel Herrera getting his option to decline and Andrew McCutchen, but they also announced it for Andrew Knapp, Travis Jankowski, Ronald Torres, Jeannie Hammer, and Ramon Rosso. Also, Cam Bedrosian's also electing free agency. I forgot to talk about that yesterday. But none of these names I'm really going to miss, right? And one name that I will miss, significantly is Ronald Torres, a guy that really came up big for the Phillies off the bench this past year, a guy that I'm going to miss greatly. He just was just such a clutch guy off the bench. I'm really, really going to miss him, right? I mean, he wasn't anything like spectacular. He wasn't a superstar. He provided some excitement, though, man. That guy, he came in here with very little expectation, and he proved to be a solid bench option. So he's a guy I'm going to miss. Probably most likely will not be back, of course, now that he just elected free agency. Travis Jankowski, and even I was actually kind of surprised at, right? I mean, I'm surprised, but also I'm not surprised at the same time. This is a guy that provides a decent amount of speed at the bench, and that's why I thought maybe he'd stick around a little bit, especially after the loss of Roman Quinn, a guy that they did not decide to outright. So Roman Quinn remains in the Philadelphia Phillies organization as of now. But Travis Jankowski also electing free agency. Make a couple, blunders. I believe that was, early June against the Washington Nationals. I'm going to say it was June 3rd or something like that, June 4th. I think it might have been June 3rd. But anyway, it was around that time. Made that horrible base running miscue. And I think he was between first and second base, and he got caught up. And got tagged out. It pretty much cost the Phillies the ball game, because I forget, I think that somebody hit a single, and I think it would have scored him. So that was just terrible, and I think it cost him from winning the ball game, at least tying the ball game. But everybody makes mistakes. But not a guy that, hits for a lot of power. Only hit one home run. Right? It was against the Washington Nationals on June 23rd, right? The three-run shot to right field. Phillies ended up losing that game. That was one of the worst games of the season. But anyway, J.D. Hammer, a guy I thought had a lot of potential, right? The glasses. Right? He had some pretty decent stuff, right? At least he had the potential to be decent, right? Or very, very good. He likes free agency. I thought this guy had a lot of potential in 2019. He still has a lot of potential, but, the Phillies decided it is time for him to go. And Ramon Rosso, not a name I'm going to miss. Just not a guy I was impressed with at all. And Andrew Knapp. Good riddance, Andrew Knapp, right? A good guy. I think Andrew Knapp's a very, very nice guy. A good clubhouse guy. Had a very good chemistry with the pitchers. Particularly Zach Eflin, right? They had a very good chemistry. And he likes free agency. This is long overdue, right? Actually a pretty decent 2020 season, which I was just very surprised at. I was shocked that he had the 2020 season that he had, and that is why he was given another chance in 2021, and he blew it, right? A switch hitter, who I thought had a lot of potential. I'm going to say around 2017, him and Jorge Alfaro thought they were going to be the future behind home plate for the Phillies. Well, it turns out I was wrong, right? And of course, the Jorge Alfaro trade got us JT Realmuto. And of course, Andrew Knapp didn't really pan out. I don't really know if he was really expected to be that great anyway. He is now gone, right? And hopefully, Rafael Marchand is either traded or he's made the backup catcher. That's what I'm hoping for. But either way, the Phillies now need a new backup catcher. It's about time that Andrew Knapp left. I'm very, very happy about that. Non-tender deadline is less than a month away, before December 2nd, which is a pretty important date if you're not familiar with the CBA, collective bargaining agreement, which is set to expire on midnight of December 2nd. A lot of the reports, a lot of baseball writers do believe that once the clock hits 12 a.m. on December 2nd of this year, the owners will lock out the players. It's a speculation. No one really knows for sure. But it's definitely not looking too good. It's definitely not looking too good. I don't mean to be negative Nelly here. I'm just trying to be objective. It's not looking too good. Do I think we see baseball next year? Yes, I do. I think they're going to be forced to reach an agreement. I talked about this yesterday, simply because of the fact that they have so much pressure on them because they've just lost so much money. They have lost so much money. They cannot afford any work stoppage, right? Whether that's affected spring training, an affected season, they're going to lose so much money, both sides. But the union, and especially the owners, they have to come to an agreement. You heard that they are already negotiating, so hopefully they come to an agreement. It's definitely possible. I think they will. I think they're going to be forced to work something out. Maybe we see a work stoppage for maybe a couple weeks or so, but I think they're going to get something worked out, right? I think they're going to get something worked out, but I'm just trying to be objective here. And of course, the baseball writers have to write about something. They have to kind of get things hyped up a little bit. You have to realize that too. That's part of their job. So the Phillies made a pretty underrated move yesterday, and he may look at this guy and say, it is what it is, but look where he's coming from. Look where this guy's coming from. Phillies were able to claim left-hand pitcher Ryan Sheriff off waivers from the Tampa Bay Rays. He's 31 years of age, but look at the name. What team is he coming from? The Tampa Bay Rays, a team that has spectacular player development, a team that especially develops pitching very, very well. He had a 5.52 ERA in 16 relief appearances this past season for the Rays, so he wasn't very good. You go back and take a look at 2020, it's kind of irrelevant, but in a short 9 2/3 innings of relief back in 2020, he did not allow a run, but not really that significant, but he's 31 years of age. He's a guy that, I don't know. I think some people are really, really excited about it. I mean, I see their point, but I think the biggest point here is coming from the Tampa Bay Rays, a team that is excellent at player development, right? They're excellent at player development. So that's one thing I really, really like, right? I mean, a team that is very good at developing pitching, right? And let's not forget here for a second that he was drafted by the St. Louis Cardinals back in 2011, so 10 years ago. But the matter of the fact is, ladies and gentlemen, that he spent time in the Tampa Bay Rays organization, on the Tampa Bay Rays roster. Anytime you just touch the Tampa Bay Rays roster, I mean, that's an amazing, that just looks amazing on your resume, right? A team that has, as I said before, like for the third time, spectacular coaching. They're just amazing, right? They know how to get things done. So I'm very, very excited about this. I'm very excited about that. But other than that, this is just kind of low risk, high reward. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not going to lose a whole lot by doing this. But this is not the end all be all. Let's not get to it of ourselves. Dave Dombrowski, this is one of the first of hopefully many moves Dave Dombrowski makes this offseason. He has a lot of work to do. So let's hope that this is not it, right? Let's hope that there's much, much more. So as I said before, free agency officially starts. So free agents can officially start signing with teams on Monday, November 8th, which is 6 days after the final game of the World Series. So that is when that could happen, right? So the Braves won the World Series this past Tuesday, which means that on Monday, right? So that's going to be the day, which is 2 days away. So weekly updates, if you remember, used to be on Sundays last year. But because of the fact that, of course, you know, there's football on Sundays, and now I kind of have more time on Saturdays to do it, I decided to switch it to Saturdays. And even at the end of last offseason, I guess it's just very, very earlier this year, I was thinking about doing it on Saturdays. I'm like, of course, I wasn't going to do it until the next offseason, but I was thinking like, hey, you know, Sundays are just not really working, because of football, you know, being on. So I think Saturdays is a better day. I think a lot of you would agree. So Saturdays is it. So, of course, you know, this video is uploaded on a Saturday. Saturday will be the new day. So I'm very happy about that. So I kind of like the kind of end off the week. This is the last day of the week. Sunday is the first day of the week. So I think it makes more sense to do it on a Saturday. Now occasionally my, you know, first off season, the 2019-2020 off season, I would occasionally kind of alternate going back and forth between Sunday and Saturday. And then just kick off the 2020-2021 off season, I, you know, made a commitment saying Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. So every week we have the last off season was on a Sunday. So that's going to be up. Now it's going to be on Saturday. Let me know what you think. Do you like that better? I sure do. So that is the news this past week. I'm very interested to see what happens. So video coming up this next week talking about Bryce Harper's chances of winning the NL MVP. We're going to be talking about Juan Soto's chance. We're going to be talking about Fernando Tatis Jr.'s chance. We're going to be talking about maybe some guys that are going to get some votes but won't win. Like maybe like a Brandon Crawford of the world, right? Maybe a Trey Turner of the world. So we're going to be talking about that. Thank you guys so much for watching the first weekly update of the 2021-2022 offseason. Welcome to Phillies Hot Stove Media. A big change. I'm going to say it again. Thank you to Phillies Hot Stove Videocast for 2.5 years of good memories. I love my new intro, which is the same music. I made sure the guy that made my intro for me, thank you to Graphic Alert on Favor for making that intro for me. He made my last intro. I made sure to tell him when I hired him to do it, I'm like, keep the same music. I want that music. So I really like the intro music I got with Bring Down from DJ Kamara. I'm a big fan of that. That's a great intro song. So I did switch up the outro music a little bit and the outro graphic. I think it looks nicer. Let me know what you guys think. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe if you have not yet. Please hit the notification bell. Please like this video. Comment on this video. Share this video. Check out the social media. Link in the description section. At Phillies Hot Stove Media, Instagram, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, at P Hot Stove Media, car text 267-225-3292, email PhilliesHotStoveMedia@gmail.com. So guys, since you watch this video, a new beginning, let me know what you all think. I'm very excited. So guys, since you're watching, I'm Luke, and I'll talk to you later. Go out there and make some more moves, Dave Dombrowski. I'll see you guys.